Hi friends, today we'll discuss about the clavicle. This clavicle is the long bone having a cylindrical shaft with two ends, medial end and lateral end. And this is the bone which transmits the weight of upper limb to the sternum. Now we'll see the side determination of the clavicle. This is the side determination. This medial end is a quadrangular in shape which should be placed to medial side, and lateral end which is flat, that is known as acromial end, which is flat above downwards, it should be placed in lateral side. And if you see the clavicle shaft, it is divided into, see, look here, this is medial 2/3 part and this is the lateral 1/3 part. This medial 2/3 part, anteriorly the shaft of the bone is convex forwards, whereas in the lateral 1/3 part it is concave forwards. And on the inferior surface, middle third of the clavicle, we'll see the one groove known as subclavian groove. In this muscle we'll see the insertion of subclavius, which acts as a cushion. These points you should keep in your mind, and then you can put the clavicle in the anatomical position. After that, there are some peculiarities for the clavicle. This is the long bone which lies horizontally, and this is the bone which starts its ossification in our body first and completes its ossification last. And it ossifies in the membrane, and this bone will ossifies from two primary centers, one secondary center, and this is the bone which does not containing a medullary cavity, and this is the bone on its middle which is pierced by the middle supraclavicular nerve through its nutrient foramen, and this is the bone which is subcutaneous. I'll repeat the peculiarities. This is the bone which does not contain a medullary cavity, and this is subcutaneous bone, and this is the bone which starts its ossification earlier in the body and completes its ossification last, and this is the bone which ossifies in the membrane, and it is ossified by two primary centers and one secondary center, and it's a long bone which lies horizontally, and it's a bone which is pierced by the middle supraclavicular nerve occasionally. This is about the peculiarities of the clavicle. Now we'll see the parts of the clavicle. This is the right side clavicle showing a superior and inferior aspect. If you see the shaft, it is divided into medial 2/3 and lateral 1/3. This medial 2/3, which is rounded and cylindrical, having four surfaces: anterior surface, superior surface, posterior surface, and inferior surface. It consists of four surfaces. Now we'll see the surfaces in detail. First, you have to know about the anterior surface. This anterior surface, which is convex forwards and it is smooth. Next, we'll see the superior surface. This superior surface on its medial area, which is rough. Next, posterior surface, which is concave backwards, and it is smooth. And after that, we'll see the inferior surface. Inferior surface on its medial area, which consists of rough oval impression, and lateral half of the inferior surface will consist of one groove known as subclavian groove. That is about the four surfaces. Now we'll see about the lateral 1/3 of the clavicle. This is the lateral 1/3 of the clavicle. It consists of two borders: anterior border, posterior border, and superior surface and inferior surface. This anterior border, which is concave forwards, posterior border, which is convex backwards, and superior surface, which was flat. We see the inferior surface. On the inferior surface, we'll see one conoid tubercle. From the conoid tubercle, one groove which extends laterally like this, that is known as the trapezoid groove. This is the trapezoid groove, and this is the conoid tubercle, and this is the trapezoid ridge. It extends from the conoid tubercle towards the lateral side. This is about the lateral 1/3 of the clavicle. Now we'll see the ends of the clavicle. This is the medial end, which is known as the sternal end, and this is the lateral end, that is known as acromial end. Medial end will consist of an articular margin which articulates with the sternoclavicular joint. This medial end consists of a medial margin which is covered by the fibrous capsule, which is mainly involved in the formation of sternoclavicular joint. And part of this fibrous capsule will continue on the inferior aspect to give an attachment for the rib as costoclavicular ligament. This is the lateral end. For the lateral end, at its margin, it is covered by the fibrous capsule and it gives attachment to the acromion process of the scapula to form acromioclavicular joint. And here lateral to the subclavian groove, we will see one nutrient foramen. Through that nutrient foramen, there will be the passage of supraclavicular artery. Now we will see the muscular attachments of the clavicle. On the anterior surface of the medial two-third of the clavicle, mostly it gives origin to the pectoralis major muscle. And if we see on the superior surface, it gives origin to the clavicular head of sternocleidomastoid muscle. This is the clavicular head of sternocleidomastoid muscle. And on the inferior surface, see, this is the inferior aspect, medial two-third part. On the inferior surface, on the medial rough oval impression, it gives an attachment to the costoclavicular ligament. Costoclavicular ligament. Lateral to the costoclavicular ligament, it gives one groove. There is a groove known as a subclavian groove, which gives an insertion of subclavius muscle. This is the subclavius muscle insertion. The margins of this muscle will give attachment to the clavipectoral fascia. Posteriorly, it gives, see here, on the posteriorly, we'll see the origin of sternohyoid muscle. Sternohyoid muscle. So, this completes the muscular attachments on the medial two-third of the clavicle. Now, we'll see the muscular attachments on the lateral one-third of the clavicle. On the lateral one-third, anterior border, it gives the origin for deltoid muscle. This is the deltoid muscle origin. And on the posterior border, it gives the insertion of trapezius muscle. Trapezius muscle insertion. On the inferior surface, we'll see a conoid tubercle and the trapezoid ridge giving attachments to the conoid and trapezoid parts of coracoclavicular ligament. These are the muscular attachments on the medial and lateral. Medial two-third and lateral one-third of the clavicle. Now we'll see the on the medial end, which is known as sternal end. On the sternal end, we'll see here articular capsule. See here, this is the articular capsule which gives attachment to the fibrous capsule. Entire it is covered by the fibrous capsule. Now we'll see the attachments on the medial end. Medial end is also called as a sternal end. At this medial end, the medial margin, entire the medial margin is covered by the fibrous capsule, which will articulate with the clavicular notch of the manubrium sternae to form the sternoclavicular joint. Here, along with the articular margin, it also gives attachments on it, superior aspect of the articular margin, which gives an attachment for the interclavicular ligament. Along with that, posterior superiorly, it gives an attachment for the articular disc, and entire the articular margin, it is covered by the fibrous capsule. Now, we'll see the acromial end. On this acromial end, we'll see the acromial facet. Margin of this acromial facet is lined by the fibrous capsule, which forms the acromion process of the clavicular acromial joint. This is about the medial and lateral end attachments. Now we'll see the ossification of the clavicle. This ossification is mainly done by the membrane except its medial end. And this ossification is mainly happened by the presence of two primary center and one secondary center at the sternal end. Occasionally we'll see another secondary center at the acromial end. Now we'll see the appearance of the first primary centers at 4th and 5th week of intrauterine life. 4th and 5th week of intrauterine life, there will be the appearance of two primary centers. Two primary centers, and they'll fuse at 45th day of the gestation. After that, at 15 to 17 years of age, the secondary center at the medial end, at 15 to 17 years of age, the secondary center which appears at the medial end of the clavicle, it fuses with the shaft of the clavicle at 21 to 22 years of age. This completes the ossification. and rarely we'll see the secondary center at the acromial end also. Now we'll see the clinical aspects. In clinical aspects, first condition is fracture of the clavicle. This fracture of the clavicle mainly occurs at the junction of the clavicle, junction between the medial 2/3 and lateral 1/3. At this junction, there will be the fractures. This is known as a weak point. Mainly these fractures are caused due to the falling from an outstretched hand. At that condition, the lateral fragment will displace downwards due to the weight of the upper limb. The second clinical condition is cleidocranial diastasis. This cleidocranial diastasis, in this condition, there is an absence of a clavicle or any impairment of the clavicle. In that condition, the shoulders will droop and they'll come forwards towards the chest. This is the second clinical condition. This completes the session. Thank you.
Thank you, friends. A lot of effort is involved in preparing these videos. A small subscribe from your side will motivate me to do more videos. Please do subscribe to my channel. To subscribe, please click on the subscribe button below the video.